This is for Monday, the 20th of December, 2021. My name's Collins, and I've come to bother you about Lawrence Krauss. Lawrence Krauss. This week I've been wondering, did Lawrence Krauss get a bad rap? Lawrence Krauss is a physicist, author, and science popularizer who got in trouble for being creepy to some students and coworkers. The controversy around his behavior led to his retiring from his professorship at the Arizona State University. On his way out the door, Lawrence Krauss wrote a rebuttal to the allegations against him, of which we can only see part for reasons of privacy. From what I can gather, he didn't just flatly deny everything and call the plaintiffs damn liars. But he did offer some slightly more nuanced explanations of the incidents they were talking about. I'll post a link to the articles that I read. Some of the charges against Krauss may have been misinterpretations. For example, if somebody overhears him make a wisecrack to a friend of his, not knowing that it's a friend and not knowing the context, that overhearer might hear something much nastier than what was intended or what actually happened. Or the listener might actually be a traumatized person, pre-traumatized, whose sensitivity is naturally very high. There's a lot of people like that. There's all kinds of people, and they come to us from everywhere, and we don't know them until we know them. So we can end up with situations like, I'm sorry I accidentally touched your leg when I was admiring the print on your dress. Or you can end up disputing the consensuality of an aborted encounter in a hotel room. This reminds me a little bit of the case of Walter Lewin, or Lewin. You remember him? He was a wildly popular physics professor at MIT for generations, I guess, who once he retired and started to go a bit daffy. Apparently he wrote some inappropriate and suggestive things to a participant in an online course who lived in another country and they'd never met each other. We don't know the details of that interchange, whatever it was, but MIT judged it egregious enough to cut off all relations with the codger, and he's still codgering along on his YouTube channel to this day. Gray areas scare me. I like it when things are perfectly clear. But there are encounters between people that are difficult to classify, especially if you don't have an agenda. Since academics are by necessity human, that means they are sexual creatures, and desire can sometimes make people act weird. Have you noticed that? Of course, there's the fuck me and you'll get an A scenario. That's not part of this case. There are, however, less overtly transgressive interactions that can make a person feel uncomfortable, especially if they perceive themselves as being an underling. This speaks to the perception of power. I think I've talked about this before. A person might feel pressure from someone they perceive to be in power, or an authority figure, whether or not the authority figure is aware of the power that they have, or they think, or somebody thinks they have. It can be a real power, like maybe that person can actually affect your success, or it can be imaginary, where the supposed authority figure isn't even aware of the power they are presumed to have. It's the perception of power that makes the threat palpable, and this is why people in academia need to be exceedingly, almost superhumanly careful. Academic institutions need to show a zero-tolerance attitude toward sexual misconduct and other erotically tinged miscreants. maybe they're needing to compensate for centuries of looking the other way. If you try to take a balanced view of these things, you run the risk of seeming to defend the patriarchy, which you don't want to do, and dismissing the accusations of women just for the sake of convenience or avoiding discomfort. And in the worst case, you might end up seeming to discredit feminism, and you don't want to be doing that either. On the other hand, zero tolerance is a concept that scares me. It sounds like no forgiveness. But then again, you know, some people just are creepy. I know this because I'm one of them. Hey, remember that time at that party at the hair studio when I grabbed your butt? I'm sorry about that. Yes, drink, no excuse. So maybe Professor Lawrence Krauss is just a very smart, nerdy, awkward guy who never quite learned how to behave around women. Or maybe he's genuinely predatory, as a preponderance of opinion seems to suggest. I, myself, cannot know. But we do seem to be living in a time right now where never touch anybody is good advice. For the more touchy-feely creatures among us, that's hard. And what it bodes for the species as a whole, I mean, if we're always living completely sanitized, both mentally and physically, that worries me too. And that's all I have to say about that. Do you have something to say about that? Please do. With any luck, I'll be back again next week to bother you some more. In the meantime, I hope that you and all your creepy physics professors will have a feine Abend Ferder.